Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play XCOM 2 Long War 2. In the previous episode, we took on a mission with Team Coffee, which unfortunately we got caught fairly early on and had to make extensive use of our flashbangs in order to survive. Unfortunately, that still didn't prevent Coco from getting heavily wounded and leaving her in the hospital for almost a month. Now, thankfully, between then and now, I have actually picked up a new mod, the Peak from Concealment, which basically changes up how some parts of concealment work. Basically, if you're in cover from a rooftop, even if you're in one of their reveal squares, they don't see you. Same thing goes for corners, doorways. Basically, as long as you're in cover in specific situations, you won't be seen. And apparently, as long as you're not visible for, I believe, about 3 squares, you won't get spotted, even if moving through a concealment square. Now, I'm assuming that means that if you don't move through 3 of their reveal squares, you don't break concealment? I'm not sure. I haven't had time to test it out. I also downloaded the Long War 2 Tactical Suppressor mod, which basically expands upon the usage of suppressors in Long War 2, because originally, all they do is reduce your infiltration time, which is alright, but that's an entire it's an entire weapon upgrade slot that could have been used for something better, like, say, a expanded magazine, or an autoloader, or a scope to increase your chances to hit. What this does is it makes it so you can take silent shots at enemies. Now, unfortunately, as we do have bullet-based guns, because if you don't kill the guy in one shot, you will break concealment, we won't be making use of it yet. Once we do get better weaponry, we will be making a lot of use out of it. So without further ado, let's get onto the map and check things out. Let's see, we got a jailbreak with Team Sun that's almost ready for infiltration. We got Team Ruby on a recover item that's also almost ready. You know what? I think even though we don't have resistance radio yet, I think it's about time we start making contact with other regions.
After we pay the initial intel cost to make contact, we'll have to scan the region for a few days before the local resistance cell comes out of hiding. Once we find them, we'll be up and running in the new region.
And I think because this current region that we're going for is going to only need 2 areas contacted before we can start getting the bonus, I think we should go for it. And as you can see, intel costs, even on rookie difficulty, are double what they are in the base game. And that's not just because we don't have a radio relay, we actually do have one in our current area.
Setting course for Sector 16, Indonesia.
Commander, using intel collected so far, we've managed to locate a resistance cell operating out of this region. It'll take us some time to scan for their exact position, though.
Yeah, well, we're not going to keep scanning, because the jailbreak mission has just reached full infiltration. It'll be extremely light, and we'll get, how many people? 3, which is going to be worth a lot for us. Now, this mission may be difficult because of the fact that, well, we're going in with a full squad of rookies, but if we can manage to stealth it, especially using our new Peak from Concealment mod, we might just pull this off. See you after the loading. Alright, here we are. Let's see, group of resistance contacts were rounded up during an advent sweep and are being held in holding cells in the area. Advent vehicles are inbound to transfer the rebels to an unknown location, so we have a limited window to break in and get these people out. If we can safely extract them, they would be an asset to resistance operations in this region. Well, no argument there, we do need more people. Now, unless I miscounted, it should only be 3. Yeah, I actually remember on one of my personal playthroughs, there was one that had 5 people, and I think they were all in the same holding cell. Let's see, how far is it to there? It's quite a distance. And an equal amount of distance to the extraction point. From what I can see in the fog, we could try going up there and down through the roof, then out. Not seeing a door. Oh well, we'll figure it out when we get there. Let's try going up top here first.
Closing on target position now.
See if we can't get a good lay of the land. Ooh, yeah, there's a trooper right there. I saw that. Let's get everybody up to the rooftop.
Tantamoto.
And a sectoid. Good thing I didn't go alongside, because it looks like their patrol path would have taken them right to us.
Position confirmed.
Might not be able to go for the side like I was planning, but hopefully. Wait, I can see a ladder there. But I'm also hoping that there might be a door at some point.
Good copy. Moving on target. No need to ask twice. Got it covered. Good to go.
Quiet!
Oh great. Someone directly ahead of us. Got an engineer somewhere. And a surveillance drone. No, just one. It just glitched out. And just poofed ahead. Looks like the only viable direction we have to go is this way. But I'm worried about the engineer I saw What is it with me today? Running around in that building here. So, let's have Sun go this way.
I have eyes on the enemy.
Okay, doesn't look like their detection radii go beyond this, or out into here. Oh, that's one other thing I forgot to mention. To balance out our abilities to hide, the detection radii of all enemies has been buffed. Alright, let's focus on getting everybody else moved.
Move.
Don't want to put anyone too close to here, just in case they do end up trapped by the detection radii. But I don't have too many options.
Affirmative. Solid copy.
And I think I'll just put Sun on Overwatch, just in case we do get caught. Okay, good. It looks like they're going the other way. Question is, what's that drone gonna do? Yeah, should have seen that coming. And of course he missed.
Enemy is still up. I've got eyes on an outbound position.
So much for being sneaky, but maybe if I can pull them off killing these drones, might be able to get back into concealment. Come on. Alright, that's one down.
And that's how it's done. Training
along with
fast.
Some loot. Come on, Sage, don't let me down. Thank you.
No longer a threat.
Just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna put everybody else into Overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
Well, except for Scarlet.
Rolling.
He is going to grab that loot.
Got it.
And then get back into cover.
Moving on target location.
Please don't come in and spot us. Please don't come in and spot us. Let's get back into concealment.
We're operating in the shadows.
Thank you. All right, Sage, because you're the most forward out of everybody, I'm going to have you moving
orders
up.
Confirmed. Moving out.
All right, there's that engineer. Yeah, looks like there's a door right here we can make use of.
Moving to designated position.
Already there.
Best to not group them up as much as possible. Of course, I say that, I've got to put Sun here.
On the move.
So that he's at least in cover. Heard something to my left. Oh well, all the same. Let's get moving. Get to these resistance members, not civvies.
We've got a hostile squad here.
Joy. Good thing you've still got movement so I can get you inside.
Confirmed.
I can only hope that everybody else is so lucky.
No need to ask twice.
And of course they're not.
Roger that.
Roll it out.
Taking a chance. Question is there some back door I can make use of that'd be closer to the extraction? I mean, there is, but it's not really all that much closer. Oh well. Let's get Neptune in here. Just so that I can close the door, lose line of sight on them, even though I already have. Because once I hack this, they're going to know I'm here.
Breaking their security.
Thankfully, I only have to do it once to get all these doors open. Ooh, should I go for it? I'm not going to get either of these. May as well go big. Nope, wasn't going to get the other one either. And Scarlet's not even going to be my specialist. So reloading to try to get the enemy protocol wouldn't matter. That is... I hate it when it does that.
Not a problem.
Okay, got this guy hunkered down. Everybody else on Overwatch, just by some freak chance, somebody enters through the front door.
We're in a concealed position.
Good. Everybody's out of their cells, everybody's concealed. Let's open the door and hope that they're gone. Not the door I was hoping to open. Thankfully, it doesn't cost any action points to do so. Alright, Scarlet, you check out the area. See if it's safe to move these. I guess you can't really call them civvies, but. Safe to move them? Good. Let's move them over here. Because from there, they should be able to make a straight shot to the extraction point. Hopefully.
Moving to designated coordinates.
And just because I want to get everybody out at the same time, let's get everybody into a position where they should hopefully be able to get to the extraction point.
Getting it done.
Looks like they called in backup.
Yeah, well, hopefully we'll be long gone by the time that backup shows up. Okay, good. They can all make it. Let's get them out first. Then our guys.
Status confirmed. We've secured a civilian contact.
No, you've secured 3 civilian contacts.
Moving out.
Already there.
And outside of 2 drones, we largely got out of here without anyone ever knowing.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
A beat-up rusty gremlin appears after the battle and bobs and weaves in front of you. Following this unit, you discover the body of a resistance specialist still holding tightly a backpack in which you find 82 supplies. After you give the soldier a proper burial, the gremlin lands on the grave and quietly shuts down. It's one last duty fulfilled. Hey, I'm not going to complain about that many free supplies. Especially considering we're not having our havens really get a whole lot at the moment. And yes, I know that's my fault, but there's a there's a method to my madness. Well then, I'm not sure if I mentioned this before, but there's always 2 types of soldiers you want to have in every squad. One is a shinobi for scouting purposes, and another is a specialist for hacking purposes. Scarlet, I'm gonna make him a shinobi, because anybody who's watched the show knows he does wield blade. Let's see, who's next? Sun, I'm gonna make an assault. Sage, I will make a grenadier. And Neptune is going to be my specialist. No other one of those characters for me to recruit, and I know there's at least a couple more. Probably not going to get to another mission, but may as well do some scanning. Because we're about to get our supply drop, quote-unquote.
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
I had high hopes for the Resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Thank you. Now, as you can see right in our monthly supply income, which is, quite frankly, pathetic, we have a loss of supplies from an unknown cause. Now, if you remember back in the first video, I mentioned that soldiers served two purposes.
Commander, we have intel suggesting the aliens are working on developments that threaten our ability to stop the Avatar project. We can conduct guerrilla operations to disrupt one of these efforts, but we'll have to choose carefully. We don't have the resources to intercede everywhere.
Commander, the Resistance has a hidden cache of resources stashed outside of Advent's reach. But that means we'll have to fly over and scan the area if we want to recover this stuff for ourselves. Commander, we'll need to completely scan this region before we can establish
contact. I get it, Bradford.
Local resistance. I'd advise we stick around and finish the job, but the choice is yours.
Now, as I was saying, back in the first video I mentioned that soldiers serve two purposes as a Haven advisor. One was to boost recruitment. The other is to root out spies. Because the thing about recruiting people to your cause is there's always the chance that they could be a spy sent to sabotage you. And in order to root them out, you actually have to send in a soldier as a Haven advisor to find them, which will then start a mission where it's just the soldier you have and a bunch of Resistance personnel. Who aren't all that great, but, well, they're all you have. Now, the thing is, you can't send in people that are infiltrating, currently in a squad, or are too low of a rank. So, they have to be squatty and available in order to pull this off. Now, the higher a person's rank is, the better they are at their job, obviously. I'm probably gonna hold off until I can get some other soldiers of a higher rank.
Commander, to aid in your efforts, we have gathered additional resources and staff at Resistance Headquarters for your use.
Or, as they really mean, the Black Market. See, Illyrium crystals don't have any of those, or I don't have enough of those to justify selling them. Stocks and hair triggers, not selling those. I am, however, going to be selling some Advent lockboxes. Question is, what do I need more of? I'll sell half of them for supplies and the other half for intel. Oh, wait. Got to check what they have for sale. Let's see. Rush research hybrid materials. Can't do that because I don't have what I need. Not going to waste intel on that. And I can't get that anyways because I don't have a scientist. Though, actually, I could buy one. Yeah, why not?
Thank you for sending additional support staff to assist me, Commander. I will make sure they are put to good use.
And I'll buy some alien alloys because I need it for the hybrid materials. Alright, let's get back to making contact.
For the Indonesian zone.
And you know what? I think I will take someone out of a squad. Let me just take a look at the different squads I have. Let's see. Can't really send them out because... Wait a minute. I thought it was Coco that was gravely wounded, not Yatsuhashi. Yeah, it's been a few days since I've played. Alright, in that case, I'll take Coco out because she's our highest ranking.
We've managed to do here.
Soldier and send her.
Managed to do with this ship.
I just wish he had lived long enough to.
Trust me, he knows. If there was one thing your father always kept in mind, it was his faith in humanity. He knew we could win, on our own terms.
Now, there's only a certain number of people you can have working at a haven. Because once you exceed that amount working, you can't have any more. Though it's not a bad idea to have more people than you can have working, just because of the fact that, well, Haven assaults work differently. Now let's see how many we've got. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You know what, I'm going to take one person off of recruiting and put them on supply. And I'll put these guys on supply, too, just so that they can actually provide us with something we can use later on. I'm going to keep one person on recruiting, because we can have more working. And we're probably going to... Wait, what? Why does it sound... Oh, whoops. I took too many people off recruiting. Because chances are we're about to lose some to them being spies. Wait, what just happened? It paused for some reason, but I didn't get a pop-up. Maybe I accidentally double-clicked. Ooh, extra supplies. Can't really build anything. I'm gonna put them on clearing this just so we can get to the... power coil quicker. What do we got? Proving ground and advent officer autopsy. I swear, I talk way faster than my brain can think sometimes. Now, unfortunately, I'm not going to be building a proving grounds yet. No, I can't even do the officer research because I need another scientist. I mean, if that's the case... I may as well work on hybrid materials. Surprised Tigan didn't have anything to say. Oh wait, now I know why I paused, because we got to 100% infill on the recover item mission. Probably going to be skipping that cutscene from now on, because it's pretty much going to be the same thing over and over again. The only thing that changes is the appearance. Now, we have very few people here, so... Let's see, 2 on recruit and 3 on intel should be good. Actually, let's make it 3 recruitment. And 2 intel. And our time's almost up, but I'm gonna keep scanning Or, actually, no, I'm gonna make... Twitchy finger. But I'm gonna make contact with New Australia. No, wait. No, that's a bad idea to do until we can get a relay here. But then again, is that something I really want to build there? It's not like I don't have enough intel. Screw it, I'm scanning and I'll place the intel here in New Australia.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
I realize that, Shen. It's why I went for the two-region area. And I'm gonna keep scanning until we get 200% infill. And then start off the episode with that mission next time.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
New target acquired, eh? See, free an important prisoner, which will get us in another scientist. Yeah, definitely gonna go for that.
Setting course for India.
No, I'm not sending a two-man squad on this. No, I'm gonna be sending in Juniper. Let's see. Need to swap out one of Ren's grenades from Medkit. Don't know why Nora's stuff doesn't show up. Not that big of a deal, though. I'll swap out her flashbang for a frost bomb.
The charges in this grenade don't seem all that powerful, but according to Shen, the liquefied gases inside should lead to an instantaneous freeze effect.
Oh yeah, because anybody who watched my original XCOM playthrough will know I adore the frost bomb. Very useful for some of the more annoying enemies. Anyways, let's start with the infiltration. And Team Ruby's is now at 200% infiltration. So, I'm gonna end the episode off there for today, and I'll see you guys at the beginning of their mission. So, if you guys like what you see, please leave a like and subscribe for future content. See you guys in the next episode.